What you see in front of you are different form factors of M.2 heatsinks. I want to test each and every one of them in this video to see what form factor of NVMe heatsinks will be the most efficient in cooling my M.2 NVMe drive. So this is the TimeTech 2TB Gen 3, and the controller temperature of this drive is reaching 94-95 degrees, and I wanted to cool down these temperatures. I searched and I found many models of M.2 heatsinks in the market, and I wanted to get the best one for my drive. And I hope that this video will also help you in getting the best M.2 heatsink for your M.2 NVMe drive. So here I have the Glotrends, like very simple M.2 heatsink. This is one side and it is very thin, and it is one of the best sold heatsinks on Amazon. So we're gonna see how efficient it is. The next one is beefier, so it is much thicker than the Glotrends heatsink, and it is from Thermalright. Thermalright is a very good name in like the cooling equipment. So it has a back plate and it has also a top plate that is aluminum. It doesn't have heat pipes. And this one is from Be Quiet. This is the MC1 Pro. It also has a back plate and a top plate. And what differentiated from the Thermalright is that the MC1 Pro from Be Quiet has a heat pipe in it. And the last one, the big one, is from Thermalright. So this is also has a back plate and it has like this big radiator on top. It has heat pipes, and on top of that, it has also a fan. So what I'm gonna do in this video is that I'm gonna test all these heat sinks, performing the same test while stressing my drive. I'm gonna start by performing the stress test on the drive without any heat sink, so to show you the temperatures that the controller is reaching, and then I'm gonna test each and every one of them, and we're gonna see at the end what heat sink will perform the best. So let's start first by testing the drive without any heat sink on it. So this is a stress test that I'll be doing on the drive without heat sink and also with all the heat sinks. Let me explain what you see on the screen here in front of you. This here is the hardware info software. So this is the drive, and this is the temperature we're looking for, the drive temperature for. This is the controller of the drive that is heating up very much, and the same temperature, it is on the top here so that you can see it better. And these are the three programs that I'm gonna use to stress the drive. The first one is that I'm gonna run Crystal Disk Mark on the drive, and then I'm gonna run the cipher command to clean the empty space on the drive, and then I'm gonna be copying a large number of small files on the drive. So let's start the stress test now with the drive without any heatsink on it. So now the three stress test programs are running together, and you notice that the temperature of the controller of the drive started to go up, and it is 73 degrees now, and it's going up degree by degree. So now the test finished, and these are the results. The maximum temperature that the controller of the drive reached is 93 degrees Celsius, and this is really very high. And the maximum temperature that the drive overall reached was 74 degrees Celsius, and this is also considered high. I wanted to note one thing about this test is that the results of the Crystal Disk Mark benchmark are not indicative of the performance of the drive, because I was stressing the drive with other software while I was performing this test. So this is in the defense of the TimeTech drive, because it is really a very fast drive. So now let's go and install the Glotrends heatsink. This is the simple one that is only on one side, and we're gonna see the temperatures that the drive will reach using the same test. So now I installed the Glotrends heatsink on the drive. Let's start the stress test. So this is Crystal Disk Mark. I'm starting it, and this is Cypher, and this is a copying of the small files. And I'm gonna consider the stress test finished whenever Crystal Disk Mark benchmark finishes its test. And you notice directly that the temperature of the controller is not spiking as quickly as without the heatsink. And this is a good sign until now. So now the stress test finished, and you saw the results. So it reduced the temperatures of the controller from without any heatsink by 9 degrees. I remind you, the temperatures without any heatsink, they were 93 degrees, and here it reached 84 degrees
which is still very high, and the overall temperature of the drive was reduced only by 1 degree, and this is not a very good result. So now let's go and perform the next test using the Thermalright Beefy heatsink. This has a backplate and it doesn't have a heat pipe. I'm gonna install it and then we're gonna do the test. So now I have installed the Thermalright Beefy heatsink. This is the one without any like heat pipes and without the fan. And we're gonna do the stress test now to see how much it will cool down the NVMe drive. So let's click on Crystal Disk Mark first to start stressing the drive. And this is Cypher. And this is the copying here of the small files. So now the stress test with the beefy heatsink, that is the Thermalright, has finished, and the maximum temperature that the controller of the drive reached was 74 degrees Celsius, and the maximum temperature that the drive reached was 71 degrees Celsius. And both these temperatures are a very good gain as opposed to the temperatures that we got without the heatsink and with the Glotrends heatsink. So without the heatsink, we dropped the temperatures by 19 degrees for the controller, and we dropped the temperatures by 6 degrees for the drive overall temperature. And as opposed to the Glotrends heatsink, we dropped the temperatures for the controller by 9 degrees, and we dropped the temperatures of the drive by 2 degrees. So let's go now and install the Be Quiet MC1 Pro heatsink on our M.2 drive and perform the same test. So now that the Be Quiet MC1 Pro is installed on our M.2 drive, let's start the test. So until now, the temperature of the controller of the drive and the temperature of the drive are both contained. So the controller is at 55 degrees Celsius and the drive's temperature is at 45 degrees Celsius. Let's see if they'll stay the same until the end of the test. So now the stress test with the MC1 Pro is finished, and we noticed a significant drop in the temperatures as opposed to the M.2 drive without any heatsink. So the maximum temperatures that were reached with the MC1 Pro installed are for the controller 68 degrees Celsius, and for the drive overall is 58 degrees Celsius. And as opposed to the drive without any heatsink, it is a 25 degrees drop in the controller's temperature and a 19 degrees drop in the drive temperature. And also the MC1 Pro performed better than the Thermalright, that is without heat pipes. So let me install now the Thermalright heatsink, that is with a fan and that is with the big radiator and with heat pipes, and let's see what are the results that we're gonna get with this very big heatsink. So now that the Thermalright heatsink with fan is installed, let's perform the stress test. So this is the controller temperature that we need to monitor along with the overall temperature of the drive. And they are really very low now, and this is a very good sign. So now the stress test is finished with the M.2 heatsink with fan from Thermalright, and the results are spectacular. So the maximum temperature the controller reached is 56 degrees Celsius only, and the maximum temperature that the drive reached was 51 degrees Celsius only. And for instance, if you want to compare the maximum temperature of the controller with the one without a heatsink, it is 37 degrees less for the controller and it is 23 degrees less for the overall temperature of the drive. And if you want to compare it with the best results that we got so far, which are the results of the Be Quiet MC1 Pro, for the controller temperature, it is 12 degrees cooler, and for the overall drive temperature, it is 7 degrees cooler. So this is the winner, of course. So let me give you now the conclusion and my opinion on all this. By the way, if you want to see the installation of each of these heat sinks individually, and especially the one with the fan, how I connected it, you can look for video links in the description. I've made videos on each one of them. And also, if you want to check out any of these heat sinks, I'm going to leave affiliate links in the description below. If you make a purchase using my link, I will gain a small percentage at no cost to you. So now let me give you the conclusion of this test. Now, as expected, the Glotrends skinny heatsink didn't decrease the temperatures as I wanted it to decrease it. So it decreased it just a little bit, but the temperatures were still high in my opinion. So I will disregard this option and I'm not gonna recommend it. The second one is the Thermalright, that is a little bit thicker than the Glotrends, but this one doesn't have a heat pipe. It decreased the temperatures quite a bit, but they stayed over 70 degrees. So this one, I would recommend it only if you have a limited budget, because it's cheaper than the other two options that I'm gonna talk about now. So the next option is a Be Quiet MC1 Pro. And this one was really very good, especially that it doesn't have a fan. It has a heat pipe and it decreased the temperatures to less than 70 degrees. And this is good in my opinion. It's a little bit expensive, but nevertheless, if you don't want the hassle to connect the fan, it is a good option. And the last option, which is the best option here in my test, it is the Thermalright HR10 2280 Pro Heatsink. So this one has a fan. It decreased the temperature drastically. And this is really recommended, especially that it is less expensive than the Be Quiet MC1 Pro. So I would recommend this one if you have a place to connect the fan, and of course, if you have a place also to put this heatsink in your PC. Let me know in the comments section below your experience with installing an M.2 heatsink on your M.2 drive. And if you have any questions or comments, feel free to put them in the comments section below, and I'll be happy to answer all your questions and all your comments. I hope that this video was useful to you. In case it was, please share it, subscribe to my channel, and give it a thumbs up. I would really appreciate it. I want to thank you all for watching. I'm Eloy from Knowledge Sharing Tech. See you in the next video.